Hello, good morning everybody. This is Puttana H, English lecturer, Department of English, Soundarya Institute of Management and Science. Very good morning. So today I would like to talk about a poem, the title called Measurements for 4th sem BCA students. See, the topic 5, the title of the poem, it's about measurements. See, measurements. The word measurements, it is nothing but how we are going to bring out a measuring something, either any kind of a thing. Here, measuring means just to identify the length and breadth of any kind of a thing. So here, the measurement, it refers to the measuring the people or measuring how a tailor is going to measure the clothes before he is going to stitch any kind of the fabrics or dress to the people. See, here the poem Measurements, it is one of the best poem that reflects the people of northeastern part of our India, especially in Assam or northeastern part of India. See here, that is Navakanta Barua. He was one of the best poet and who has written this poem in Assam, and later it has been translated into English. See, measurement, it refers to the people, those who are living especially in the northeastern part of our country before the independence of our India and even after the independence of India. So how the people are living and what about their social, economical, cultural and ethnic, you know, the problems, especially the people of northeastern part of our India. See here, the poet, that is Navakanta Barua, he speaks about the problems, social, economic and even ethnic problems of northeastern part of our India. Because in the very beginning of the poem, he speaks about, let's go to the tailors to get measured. See, it is a very, very, the lamenting word. Let's go on and get measurements. See, what is the main motto of the poet? The main motto of the poet is, he wants to express the inner pain, agony and lamenting about the people of northeastern part of India. Why? Because before the independence of our country, the people have been neglected, they have been least bothered about, you know, the identity. But see here, the measurement, it refers to how the poet is going to ask the people a give measurement, and for every, you know, the every clothes or dresses that they are going to use for future days. See, here is how the poet, he laments about the condition and he laments about the agony, sorrow and melancholy of the people of northeastern part of India, especially Assam. See here, measurements, the poet asks the readers, hey, let's go and give measurement to the tailor. And just you have to give measurement to the, you know, the length and breadth of the hands and your chest and the neck, collar and even handcuffs. Just you go on and give measurement to the tailor, whether he is going to, you know, the measure and whether he is going to stitch, you know, the fabrics according to your size or not. That is, you know, the uncertain. But the main motto of the poem is to, hey, let's go to the tailor and give measurement to the fabrics or the clothes. And whether the tailor may come and then take the measurement, and according to the measurement, whether he is going to cut the fabric and whether he is going to stitch the garments or not. See, that is, you know, the immaterial, that is uncertain. So what is the meaning of this one? The main, the purpose and the motto of the poet is the government or the people, those who are going to rule, these people are just, they are going to identify, you know, the identify, you know, the number of people, but rather than they are not going to identify the what sort of problems and what kind of social, economical and cultural problems that these people are going to face. And see, let us go and meet the tailor to give measurements to our dress or, you know, the clothes. So that is only the message. See, whoever the people, those who are working, especially the employees, they especially the governing body, just they are going to identify the number of people, but they never ever been to those remote places. And what about the social, economic and religious as well as the cultural diversity, the problems? See, throughout the poem, the poet speaks about Navakanta Barua. He speaks about just go to the tailor and give measurements about the shirts or the pants, whatever the dress the people are going to wear, you just give out, you know, the measurement of your neck, hands and shoulder. So afterwards, whether the tailor is going to cut the fabric and stitch for your garments, that is absolutely uncertain. So what is the meaning? The message is very simple. The people, those who are ruling our nation, just they want, you know, the number of people. And the number of people, that is only a measurement. Measure the people in terms of numbers, but they are not going to measure the people's problem, social, economical, cultural and religious, you know, the diversities. And that's why it is only a measurement. It is only a measurement of the people under the bodily measurement, means only physical identification of the people, but not the social problems, not the cultural problems, not the religious problems, and not the economical or unemployment problems of the people, those who are living northeastern parts of our country. So here, Navakanta Barua, he says, under the tailor who is going to measure, you know, the measure the size of the garments, whether he is going to take the measurement and whether he is going to cut the fabrics and then stitch the clothes or not. So it is a total confusion that whether the people are really going to happy and whether the people are really going to protect by the laws of the government, laws or the rules of the government. So here is a message. The people are just, they are lined up and they are standing one after the another in front of the tailor to give out their measurements to the tailor in order to stitch the fabrics. And you know, no one should ask what sort of the clothes or the fabrics that the tailor is going to stitch, and when he is going to stitch, and when give out the garments after stitching to these people, that is completely uncertain. So here is a message that the ruling people, the people, those who are ruling, the publics, and especially in Assam, the people have been completely neglected. Why? Because, you know, not only topographical condition, because, you know, the people of Assam, they have different ethnic background, they have a different, the cultural background, social background, and economical background. So thinking that the people, especially those who are ruling the, state, and just they wanted to And the give out the measurement means only the number of people, not the problems of the people what they are facing. So this is very, very pathetic. The poem, it is all about a lamenting, and it is one of the sarcasm. And how the officials, the government employees, how they are going to take, you know, the number of people, those who are living in that particular area, rather than they are going to, you know, the assess or identify the exact, you know, the social problems, economical or cultural problems of these, you know, the regionality. So this is very, very lamenting. This is a very, very pathetic one. So that is Navakanta Barua. He brings out a tremendous change, especially the people, those who are ruling our nation. They want number of people, they want physical number, but rather than, you know, the social, psychological and economical and cultural problems of these, you know, the neglected territories. So that's why let us just line up and let us go and meet the tailor and let us give out the measurements, under the measurement of our neck, shoulder, legs, hands, and, you know, the see, and let us not ask when the tailor is going to stitch the fabric and when he is going to make ready the garment and then give it back to us. So this is one of the very, very pathetic condition of our country, where the people have been neglected, and the people, those who are living in isolated territory, those who are living in interior, you know, the border areas, so they have been neglected, not only economically, socially, culturally and religious aspects. So okay, so I hope that you know, the Navakanta Barua, he brings out a very, very pathetic condition of the people of Assam, and those who have been neglected, and just they have been asked to give out the number of people, those who are residing, rather than the problems that they are facing, whether it is a social, cultural, economical or religious aspects. So I hope that all of you have understood well how this measurement, just measuring the people only in terms of physical presence or only in terms of numbers, but behind the numbers there is a lot of you know, the uncountable, infinite problems, suffering, sorrows, you know, the negligency, and there are so many you know, the problems the people are facing even day to day. So I hope that everybody has understood well. Thank you for listening, and wish you best of luck for your exam.